When you speak, confusion fades. Just a word, and suddenly I'm not afraid. 'Cause you speak, and freedom reigns. There is hope, and every single word you say.
Welcome to today's service. As you can see, we're not in our home church. We're here in Parish Church, Llantrisant, part of our road trip around our ministry area. So the people today who will lead us in prayer and read the gospel for us are parishioners who worship in this church. So thinking about that, here's Mary to read today's gospel for us.
The Gospel according to St. Luke. While they were on their way, Jesus came to a village where a woman named Martha made him welcome. She had a sister, Mary, who seated herself at the Lord's feet and stayed there listening to his words. Now Martha was distracted by her many tasks, so she came to him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to get on with the work by myself?" But the Lord answered, "Martha, Martha, you are fretting and fussing over so many things. Only one thing is necessary. Mary has chosen what is best. It shall not be taken away from her." This is the word of the Lord.
When you dig a little deeper into what seems on the surface to be a nice story about two sisters and their encounter with Jesus, you realise there is so much more depth to it. It is so much deeper than just two quarrelling sisters. Martha, by welcoming Jesus into the home that she and Mary share, is showing hospitality. But she starts to get angry about her sister seemingly lazing about and not helping in the preparations. Then she takes it further by asking Jesus, "Lord, don't you care that my sister's left me to do all the work? Tell her to help me." It must have been a shock to Martha when Jesus tells her that Mary had chosen the better part, which he says will not be taken from her. Martha's problem is not just with her working and serving, but also that she is distracted. The word distracted in verse 40 has a connotation of being pulled or dragged in different directions. Perhaps what Jesus is really saying to Martha is to break free from the stereotype of the woman of the household preparing everything for the guest, and to act more like Mary and listen to Jesus. Because it's in that listening that Martha would learn that she's valued not for what she does or how well she does it, but for who she is as a child of God. Right now, we're asking you to leave any tasks you might be doing, and just for a few moments, don't worry about anything else, just be still.
Be still, my heart, be still, my soul, that I might hear your voice. Your word is true, I wait for you, that I might hear your voice. Holy Spirit, come, mend me in the broken places, lead me to your joy, and I will sing your praises. Holy Spirit, come, mend me in the broken, lead me to your joy, that I
Today's collect. Almighty God, send down upon your church the riches of your spirit and kindle in all who minister the gospel your countless gifts of grace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Sometimes when I listen to people talking about a theme that comes up on a regular basis is how fast-paced everything is nowadays. I fail to see that, although it's probably my age. They talk about how much time people spend on computers or phones, and how in their day they didn't have all these electronic games. They went out and kicked a football around, or just hung around with friends. And some of that is true. And these days, we're living at a faster speed. But did people 40 or 50 years ago actually spend more time listening to God? I leave that to you. Whatever you have forgotten to do this week, right now, in this moment, lay them all before God, in the words of the confession. Almighty and merciful God, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with all our heart, and we have not loved others as Christ loves us. We are truly sorry. In your mercy, forgive us. Help us to amend our lives, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your name. Amen. May God, our Father, who by our Lord Jesus Christ has reconciled the world to himself and forgives the sins of all who truly repent, pardon and deliver us from all our sins and grant us the grace and power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shirley will now lead us in prayer.
Our God is always ready to listen. Let us pray to him now. Father, continue to pour out your gifts on the church so that many may be saved and our faith may grow strong and bear much fruit. God of love, we put our trust in you. Look with mercy on the conflicts of our world. Realign our values and goals until they are in line with your will and our laws and expectations reflect your justice and love. God of love, we put our trust in you. Bless our homes and families and all our neighbours and friends. Train us to listen to one another with full attention and to recognise one another's gifts. God of love, we put our trust in you. Encourage the hesitant, curb the overpowering, heal the sick, refresh the exhausted, soften hardened hearts. Open the eyes of the complacent and comfort all who are sad. God of love, we put our trust in you. Welcome into your eternity all those who have died in the faith. May we in turn share with them the joy of living with you forever. God of love, we put our trust in you. Thank you, Lord our God, for the hope you have given us through Christ, which enables us to enjoy living in eternity, even while we still journey here. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. And we'll say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
When you attend an on-site service, and everyone there is saying together the creed, There is a power to it all. You are declaring what you believe. Online, it's different. There is a different feeling, a feeling of a different kind of power, that people on their own, with family or with friends, people we can't even see, are declaring what they believe. That thought is incredible. So please join with me now in the baptismal creed. Do you believe in God the Father, the Creator of all? I believe and trust in God the Father. Do you believe in His Son, Jesus Christ, the Saviour of the world? I believe and trust in God the Son. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life? I believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You see, we need time to talk to God, just as in any relationship. Likewise, we do need to set aside time to listen to God. And of course, we need to do what we feel we are led to do. That is the complexity of relationships. In our next worship song, Lauren Daigle tells us that God gives us everything.
Even the sparrow has a place to lay its head. So why have clothed in brilliant red, still I'm the one you love more than this. You give me everything, you give me everything, you give me everything I and pull at your command, so you can steal my heart with your hand. You tell the seasons when it's time for them to turn, so I will trust you even when it hurts. Thank you.
Looking back at our gospel reading, Luke leaves us in the dark. We don't know how Mary and Martha got on after Jesus left. Did Martha ever get to sit and listen to Jesus? What we do know is that Jesus invites us all, when we're worried or distracted by things going on around us, to just sit and relax in his presence, to hear his words and to know that we are loved and valued as his children, that we can be renewed in faith and given strength to cope. Grace and peace be with you and keep you in the love of Christ. Father of glory, holy and eternal, look upon us now in power and mercy. May your strength overcome our weakness, your radiance transform our blindness, and your spirit draw us to that love shown and offered to us by your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We would like to say thank you to our wonderful host for making us welcome here at Llandrisant, Shirley for our prayers today, and Mary for reading the Gospel. Zoom evening prayer is on Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. Let's say the grace together.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Mary may not have known what she was doing when she sat at Jesus' feet and listened. She was breaking so many rules by not following Martha in her busyness. The irony is, by sitting, she was making a stand. A stand that still goes on today, when people think you're odd because you have a faith. In our last worship song by the Newsboys, we are encouraged that no matter what the cost, we still need to stand. For the God we know, and more importantly, the God that knows us.
You are all in our prayers. Please join us next week. Goodbye.
Who will I be when trouble comes calling for me? Will I live the way I believe? When I'm backed up against the wall, what kind of heart do I have in my chest? Does it beat for my Savior or just for my flesh? What will I do in the moment that everything falls? I'm gonna stand in a world that's breaking, stand for a truth unchanging. I'm not ashamed, I've considered. They can call me a fool or stubborn for following you, for trusting without any proof. But I've seen you here through it all. So what kind of person do I wanna be? Am I committed to you or committed to me? What will I choose? The second that everything falls, I'm gonna stand in a world that's breaking, stand for a truth unchanging. I'm not ashamed, I've considered the cost. I'll stay right here at the foot of the cross and stand. You deserve all of me.